For the first time in more than 10 years, a convicted killer from our area will be put to death. He's accused of murdering an elderly couple more than a decade ago. 42.9's Emily Maha spoke with people from the community to find out what they think about a local man facing the death penalty. She's new tonight.
I'm here tonight in the city of Howe, where an elderly couple was brutally murdered in their home 13 years ago. Tomorrow, the man who killed them, James DeRosa, will be put to death. I spoke with several neighbors in the area, none of whom wanted to speak with me on camera, but they tell me the last month has not been easy for this community.
There's been talk about it. There's mixed emotions on it.
Officer Kim Lyles is the assistant police chief in Howe. She tells me what neighbors are saying about this murder.
There's probably more waiting for the execution than not. A lot of people, they've been waiting for the date.
That date, tomorrow, June 18th, is the day this man, James DeRosa, will be executed at the Oklahoma State Penitentiary in McAllister. In 2000, DeRosa and an accomplice talked their way into the home of Curtis and Gloria Plummer. He then stabbed the couple multiple times, slit their throats, and stole $73, along with the couple's pickup truck.
The effects of this, as I know them in the DeRosa case, are, you know, besetting upon two kind-hearted elderly people at their home, essentially a home invasion, and you know, stabbing and killing them while begging for their lives. I mean, it's one of the most horrible scenarios you can think of.
District Attorney Jeff Smith says he will be there when DeRosa is given a lethal injection of potassium chloride. He tells 4029 News he received an information packet from the Attorney General, right, the same one received by the victim's family, detailing what he can expect to see at tomorrow's execution.
They just want to prepare mostly the victims, mostly the family, for what might happen. So, I mean, they provide pictures and diagrams and scenarios. So really, when they show up, they're not surprised about anything.
Smith says he hopes after tomorrow's execution, the family of Curtis and Gloria Plummer will be able to start the healing process.
As a sitting district attorney in this county, I hope that when tomorrow comes and goes and this execution is over with, that the family can gain some type of closure, that they can gain some type of peace and feel a sense of justice.
District Attorney Smith says his office takes the death penalty very seriously. He says DeRosa appealed his case all the way up to the Supreme Court of the United States, where it was denied before a date for his execution was set. Emily Maha, 4029 News.
DeRosa had a clemency hearing about a month ago. The board denied the request for life in prison without parole.